This week on The Wire, house prices defy gloomy predictions, property better than shares, gold and cash, and mortgage rates fall below 2%. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate. We can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment and more. Now please like, comment and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So let's kick it off with our top story for the week, house prices defy gloomy predictions. So CoreLogic's latest home value index shows that the national median dwelling values declined by just 0.8% over the past 3 months. Hobart, 1%, Adelaide and Canberra both 0.7%, and Darwin, 0.4%, recorded quarterly dwelling price increases despite the predictions of many experts that house prices would collapse after COVID-19 struck. Real estate economist Dr. Bear with me with the name here, Diaswati Madiasamo, says that whilst COVID-19 hit us swiftly this year and threw the Australian economy and property markets into turmoil, things settled down within the property market quicker than initially thought. Prices in most capital cities and regions remained higher than a year ago, and that's compared to July 2019. House prices are higher in 6 out of 8 capital cities, with Melbourne 9%, Sydney 12%, Brisbane 4%, Adelaide 2%, Hobart 6%, and Canberra 7%. Tasmania, up 10%, led the growth in regional areas, followed by Queensland, 4.7%, New South Wales, 4.5%, and Victoria, 4.4%. And now for our next story. So property better than shares, gold, and cash. So property is a better investment option than shares, gold, super, or cash in the current environment. And that's according to a survey by comparison website Finder. Finder's latest RBA cash rate survey found a third of analysts and economists rated property as the best investment option, followed by shares at 21%, gold 14%, superannuation 11%, and cash 7%. All of the respondents expected a cash rate hold in August, though most forecast a rate increase in either 2021 or 2022. Finder noted that a surprisingly high percentage of those surveyed believe now was also a good time for homeowners to put their property on the market, whereas only 25% said homeowners should wait. Finder Insights manager Graham Cook said, "This environment has also pushed interest rates lower than ever. We've just seen the first sub 2% loan hit the market, and that could be a sign of things to come. With many investors avoiding the market, banks are eager for new business, especially for owner-occupied customers, and it's the ultimate borrower's market," he says. Now, guys, for our final story of the week, mortgage rates fall below 2%. So banks are offering special deals, including honeymoon interest rates below 2% to win new business from homebuyers, says Sally Tindall, Director of Research at Rate City. One lender is offering a variable rate home loan of 1.99%, and more lenders are expected to follow suit as competition for new mortgages intensifies. Now, another lender is offering cash backs of up to $4,000 for health, education, and emergency service workers. Now, Reserve Bank figures for May show the average owner-occupier was paying 3.26% interest on their existing home loan, while those that applied for a new home loan would pay 2.93% on average. Now, many of the best deals are available to new customers who have big deposits, such as those refinancing who have built equity in their properties. Now, introductory rates typically revert to a high interest rate after 1 or 2 years and could cost borrowers more in the long term unless mortgage holders commit to regularly refinancing their home loan, and that comes from Sally Tindall. Well, guys, they're the top stories for this week. Now, please don't forget, like, comment and share this video and follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, that's action. Thanks a lot, guys, and bye for now.